Good morning. Newton's second law of motion is an equation.
Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Net force equals mass times acceleration, where both force and acceleration are vectors. Newton's second law of motion. The sum of the forces, or the net force, equals mass times acceleration, where both force and acceleration are vectors. That is Newton's second law. Now, let's talk about this symbol. This symbol is the uppercase Greek letter sigma. And it means the summation of. So sigma F means the sum of the forces acting on the object, or objects you're summing the forces on. And M and A are the mass and acceleration of the object or objects you're summing the forces on. Now, the best way to understand Newton's second law is to do an example problem. So Bo, could you please read the problem?
You apply a force of 5.0 newtons horizontally to a 1,627 gram book that is at rest on a horizontal table. If the force of friction between the book and table is 3.6 newtons, A, what are the magnitudes of all the forces on the book?
Bo, please stop there. We'll get to part B in a little bit. So we have a book with a mass of 1,627 grams, and we are applying a force of 5.0 newtons on it, and we're trying to figure out all the forces that act on the book while we are applying that force on it. So, Bobby, please list all the givens.
Okay, the force applied equals 5.0 newtons. The force of friction equals 3.6 newtons. The mass of the book equals 1,627 grams. Oh, and the book starts out at rest, so the initial velocity equals zero.
And Billy, we're doing a problem with forces in it, so what should we do next?
We need to draw the free body diagram.
Okay, Billy, go ahead. Tell me what forces to add to the free body diagram.
Okay. There is the force of gravity, which is down, and the force normal, which is normal to or perpendicular to the table, and a push, so it is up. There is also the force you applied, which is to the right, and the force of friction is acting to prevent the movement or slow the book down, so it is opposite the direction the book ends up moving, so the force of friction is to the left.
Very nice, Billy. Part A asks for the magnitudes of all the forces acting on the book. And it turns out that two of those forces are given in the problem statement, the force applied and the force of friction. And we have an equation for the force of gravity. Bo, could you please figure out the magnitude of the force of gravity acting on the book?
The force of gravity equals the mass of the object times the acceleration due to gravity, so 1,627 times negative 9.81.
Actually, we need to convert the mass to kilograms first, because a newton is a kilogram times a meter per second squared.
And the acceleration due to gravity is positive 9.81 meters per second squared.
Right, so let's convert the mass. Multiply 1,627 grams by 1 kilogram over 1,000 grams, and we get 1.627 kilograms. So the force of gravity equals 1.627 times positive 9.81, which is 15.961, and with two sig figs, that is 16 newtons.
Great. Now we have the magnitude of the force of gravity. In order to figure out the magnitude of the force normal, we need to use Newton's second law. Now, because force is a vector, anytime you use Newton's second law and you sum the forces, you need to identify the direction in which you are summing the forces. Let's start by summing the forces in the y direction. Bobby, please look at the free body diagram and tell me what forces are acting on the book in the y direction.
In the y direction, there are two forces, the force normal and the force of gravity.
And Bobby, please tell me if those forces are positive or negative.
How would I know that?
Remember, up is positive, down is negative.
Oh, yeah.
So the force normal is up and positive, and the force of gravity is down and negative. Thanks, Bo.
You're welcome.
So then, the net force in the y direction is equal to the positive force normal minus the force of gravity, which is then equal to mass times the acceleration in the y direction. Now, I know that this particular piece sometimes can be confusing for students, so let's take a closer look at it. The net force in the y direction just means the sum of the forces in the y direction, so that's the force normal, which is positive because it's up, minus the force of gravity, negative because it's down. So that's the net force in the y direction. But the net force is always equal to mass times the acceleration. So we sum the forces in the y direction, that's the acceleration in the y direction. So the net force in the y direction is both equal to the force normal minus the force of gravity, and it's equal to mass times the acceleration in the y direction. Therefore, the force normal minus the force of gravity is equal to mass times the acceleration in the y direction.
Thanks. I was wondering about that, but now it makes sense.
Good. Now, Billy, what is the acceleration in the y direction of the book while I am applying a force on it?
Positive 9.81 meters per second squared.
Actually, no, Billy, that is the acceleration due to gravity here on planet Earth, or little g. That's not the acceleration in the y direction of the book itself while I'm pushing on it. So look at it again and tell me what is the acceleration in the y direction of the book while I apply a force.
The book doesn't move up or down while you push on it, so the acceleration in the y direction of the book is zero.
Yes, the book doesn't move up or down, which means the acceleration in the y direction of the book is going to be equal to zero. Anything times zero is zero, which means that the force normal minus the force of gravity is equal to zero, and now we can add the force of gravity to both sides of the equation. And therefore, the magnitude of the force normal equals the magnitude of the force of gravity, which is approximately 16 newtons. So again, Newton's second law helped us to figure out the magnitudes of the forces. The free body diagram shows us the directions. That actually completes part A. Bo, could you please read part B?
Part B, what is the acceleration of the book?
To find the acceleration of the book, we need to use Newton's second law again, only this time we're going to sum the forces in the x direction. Bo, please look at the free body diagram and tell me which forces are acting in the x direction and whether they are positive or negative.
The force applied is to the right, so it's positive. The force of friction is to the left, and so it's negative.
And we know that the net force in the x direction is equal to mass times the acceleration in the x direction. Therefore, the net force in the x direction is equal to the force applied minus the force of friction, and it is also equal to mass times the acceleration in the x direction. And we're solving for the acceleration in the x direction, so we can divide the whole equation by mass. And we get that the acceleration in the x direction of the book is equal to the force applied minus the force of friction, that quantity divided by the mass of the book. And now we can substitute in numbers. And we get 5.0 minus 3.6 all divided by 1.627, which works out to be 0.86048, or 0.86 meters per second squared. So Newton's second law helped us to figure out the magnitudes of all the forces and the acceleration of the object.
Mr. P?
Yes, Bo?
Could you please explain how the dimensions for acceleration in that equation work out to be meters per second squared?
Actually, you know what, Bobby? Why don't you explain that one?
Sure. Dimensions-wise, the acceleration ends up being newtons divided by kilograms. We can substitute kilograms times meters per second squared for newtons. We need to flip the guy and multiply, and the guy in the bottom is actually kilograms divided by one. So we flip the guy and multiply by one over kilograms, and kilograms cancel out to leave just meters per second squared.
Exactly. Now, please remember, anytime you're working with forces, to draw the free body diagram or force diagram. One more thing. Because all of our forces were constant, that meant that the net force was constant, which meant that the acceleration was constant. The acceleration equaled a number. Therefore, we could use the uniformly accelerated motion equations with this problem. We could, for example, because we know the initial velocity of the book is zero, the acceleration of the book is 0.86048 meters per second squared, we could use the UAM equations to figure out how long it would take the book to go through a displacement of 1.0 meters. That's an example. We're not going to do that today. However, we will certainly do things like that in the future. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.